In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to put the sides of the pencil case together. So first of all, there's some equipment that's going to be needed, and starting from right to left, we're going to need a wet cloth, we're going to need a claw hammer, pincers, a nail punch, some PVA adhesive, that's polyvinyl acetate, the wood glue, and we've got the frame. We can see it's just assembled here, not glued together yet, just placed as we go with that. And there's a little stick there as well at the bottom of the picture that you can see is going to be used for spreading the glue. So to start off with, anyway, I'm showing a line that's halfway across the lap joint, and that's going to be kind of a guide for our pins to go in. And I'm marking two points now that are kind of spaced roughly thirds along the wood. And we need to keep arranging the piece of the frame as we see here, and going back to that there, I'm going to put the pin in. I've exaggerated a slight bit for the video that it's at a slope, just to until the tip of the nail comes through the head. Now this is known as skew nailing, at when it's placed in at an angle. If the nails were placed in straight, they would come straight back out if they were tugged on or pulled on, and by putting them at a slightest bit of an angle, it makes sure that they're not that easily retracted from that. Now it doesn't need to be as much as what I've shown there. And we press the two pieces together, and the nail heads will make an indent into the sharp pieces of the sides. And I'm labeling these here, label it A or B or 1 or 2 or whatever you want to put them on, so that you know that side will match up. Then I'm going to take this other side. I'm not putting any glue on this yet, I just want to get the nails right. And you can see I'm just putting the spacing again for the nails, not too close to the edge, roughly in the center, the slightest little bit of a skew on the nail, and we want it straight in the other two directions so it won't come out the sides either. And just tack it in, holding the edge is flush, and the nails are coming through there but not very far, so I'll give them another little tap to get them in a little bit further. And again, I need to label those pieces. And now, because the nails of where they are, I cannot turn them upside down and tap them on the bench. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take it over to the vise. You can see I've taken my panel pins as well too. And I'm going to place it upright in the vise. It's going to keep the piece straight for me as well. And I can take my panel pins. This could be done actually separate from the way I'm doing it here. It could be placed on the bench and do that first of all. But having the supporting piece underneath the nail will actually prevent it from bursting out the piece of wood as well, so it's probably better doing it like this. And I'm going to turn this around just for the purposes of the video. So it's finding the holes again, put it back into the vise. And you can see on the end there that there is a bit of a skew on the nail, one more so than the other. And what you don't want is it to come out the side, so make sure it's quite straight in the two directions that you're going in, but have that skew then, it's kind of like a dovetail type shape. And labeling these again, that's all sitting flat on the bench, there's no rocking there of the piece, and just so that we know that we can identify each of the corners that have to go together. So that brings me to the next part. The pincers that I have here is if a nail goes wrong, we can use the pincers to roll it out, to take out the panel pin. I haven't had to use it here. And the glue, I'm spreading some of the glue into the middle of the piece, and the little stick that I mentioned earlier on, it can be used now to spread the glue around evenly over the surface of the joint. Once I have that done, I want to offer the pieces back into the fine bill center on the holes that they've already made, and I can send them home, I can drive them home. Driving them home is a term that's used for put the nail in flush to the edge of the wood. And flush is a term that's used on the edges. That just means that they're even. So you can see I'm rubbing my thumb over them. Probably not the wisest thing to do. If there was a sharp piece on it, it could end up getting cut. But just to highlight the fact that those nail heads are flush. So down to the last piece, and again, always check to see that the labeling or the lettering is actually matching up to this. Put a little bit of glue in there, and I spread at onto over the lat of the joint. Offer them back again, making sure that the letters are matching up, and they'll find their own center again. Just going to stand it up this time. Could be putting a vise if you like to keep it steady, but it should be pretty straightforward. And again, you can see that there's a skew on the nails as they're being driven in, and any excess glue, just give them a wipe off. And this is our frame. Now, the only thing that we should really be doing now at this stage, it should have been checked when the piece was dry, is that the piece is actually square. So we take the square to the edges here and just offer them up to see if the edge should be, that should be square. Check it out on the end. Same too on the other side. And providing that your pieces have been cut well, you should be able to get the piece square. Another method of checking it to see if it's square is measuring the diagonals, so that one diagonal distance should be the same as the other diagonal distance, and that ensures that the piece is square, and that leaves us ready then for the next part of the project, which we'll be putting on the base and doing the top part. Normally when that would be dry, we would punch the nail heads, but just for the purpose of doing it at this stage of the video, you want to sink the nail heads a little bit below the surface, and in the next video I show how to apply the filler and clean the pieces up when the base is actually attached to the frame. If the nail head isn't punched enough into the wood, it won't take enough filler to stay in it, and if the nail isn't punched in sufficiently into the wood, there will be no grip for the filler, and it'll probably end up just falling out or creating a lump on the top of the piece. Thanks again to Ben for doing the video for me here today.